Hey everyone, it's your buddy Graphic back with another video, and today we're going to show you guys one of the quickest ways to make gold in New World. A lot of people have been wondering this just recently. What's the good way to make gold? And it's not just about selling or crafting or, you know, going out and getting good gear to put on the trading post. There's a many ways to do it. And this is one of the more unique ways that a lot of people haven't really utilized quite yet. And I used it quite a bit during the closed beta. And I'm going to give you some of the closed beta pricings in gold that I was able to make during the closed beta, obviously a 2-week beta instead of this, you know, 3 to 4 day alpha that will probably be a little bit less relevant. I do want to talk about, you know, first off, Syndicate faction missions pretty much give you, or, you know, obviously not just Syndicate, but faction missions in general. Obviously, this works with Syndicate, Covenant, and Marauders, but you can see that they don't give you much gold. You know, 7.19 coins, 8.10 coins. You have a 7.94 coins, 6.75 coins, 2.25 coins, and 6.75 coins from this. And we are in Everfall, by the way, if you guys didn't notice. So Everfall, you don't make much from the actual faction mission. So where do you make your gold when it comes down to faction missions? Well, it's based on what you buy, and we're going to kind of cover that today. So you can see some of the reputation you gain, some of the tokens you gain, and all of that. So keep that all in mind. Let's say on average we gain about 300 and, well, some of these gain 400 tokens. So we're going to go with about 400 tokens on average, because these two on the side give you 400 something tokens. This one gives you 320. We're going to say about an average of 400 tokens on the bottom. If you do the PvP missions as well, about 400 as well. So let's jump into buy rewards and see what there is available to us. So a lot of you guys have probably, at least used the Minor Rune of Holding before. Maybe you have never heard of it. Well, the Minor Rune of Holding is used to create bags in New World. So something that everybody needs a lot of. Definitely when you're gathering, you're going to want a bigger bag. You're going to want a better bag, maybe one with, you know, a few perks. So a lot of people use this to actually make bags and make even more money. But the biggest way to make money, like I said, with faction missions is going to be buying up these Minor Rune of Holdings. And obviously, if you're in the Scrivener, you can buy up the next tier in line, which is going to be Major Rune of Holdings. And then if you continue on to Chronicler, we can actually grab, here it is, Greater Rune of Holding. So it's 5,000 faction tokens. And it gets a little bit more expensive per, obviously. That's, you know, makes perfect sense. We have the Grand Rune of Holding as well, which is going to be that tier 5. So there's going to be a massive amount of people looking for these holdings because, like I said, this is the way to make or craft, craft those awesome bags that everybody's going to be wanting during this, you know, release. So I want to talk about the tier 2 through 5. What's the amount of gold you actually make per, selling one on the market? So this was specific with my server during the closed beta. And just keep that in mind. But, you know, with tier 2, 500 to 650 gold. And you can see here, that's just one run of 3 missions at the, you know, you'll have even a little left over because 3 missions, obviously being around that, I guess if we were going 400 a piece, about 1,200 syndicate tokens I needed, and it's 1,000 syndicate tokens, and obviously using 250 gold as well to buy. But you can sell, like I said, right around 500 to 650 gold per tier 2 holding. So there you go. You're making 250 gold to 350 gold very, very quickly by just doing, like I said, those 3 missions, and it's giving you so much other things as well. Territory standing, like I said, rewards based on, it's actually giving you a little bit of gold too. I think it was like 30 gold it probably would have gave you. So you're making even a little bit more than that. But that's with the Minor Rune of Holding. Obviously, this continues to scale a little bit. So if we go down to something like the Major Rune of Holding, and I also want to say, guys, by the way, think of how much money you're going to make if you're level, 40 through 60 and you're doing faction missions in higher zones. So maybe like Brightwood or even Weaver's Fen or Morningdale. If you're doing these in Eastburn or just somewhere that has very, very fast, PvE or PvP missions, and you're able to do them very, very quickly, and you're also a higher level, so you get, granted more faction tokens, you can take advantage of this system very, very quickly to make a lot of gold in New World. So if we jump onto the Tier 3 Major Rune of Holding, here you're going to see about 1,000 to 1,400 in gold of, really a buying price on the trading post. So that's going to be about 500 to 900 gold per Major Rune of Holding. Obviously, it does take a little bit more of a grind to buy these, as it's about 3,000 faction tokens, but you have to keep in mind, like I said, you'll be in better areas getting more or generating more faction tokens at the point of Chronicler for sure. I do want to talk a little bit more, or I guess this was under Scrivener, but I do want to talk a little bit more about Chronicler as well. So you see Greater Rune of Holding. This is tier 4. This is one that costs 1,000 gold. So you make 2,200 to 2,800 per book of these. So this is about 12,000 gold, or not 12, I think it's a 12,000. That's not 12,000. That's 1,200 to about, I would say 1,200 to, well, it depends how you look at it, but 1,800 gold. So you're making about 1,500 gold per Great Arena of Holding, which is absolutely insane. You know, like I said, you're going to have to get a lot of, or you're going to have to farm a lot of those faction tokens, but you're going to be doing those anyway to maybe put territories into conflict. This is just definitely, like I said, something worth buying if you are ahead of the game. If you're, you know, level 25, 35, 45, while everyone else is stuck around that 15 to 25 zone because you're able to play more that day ahead, or, you know, just, it's going to be one way to, like I said, make a ton of money in the early, you know, early stages of the release. As we go to the final greater or grand rune of holding, which is going to be, by the way, the tier 5. This is one that sells. This is a, kind of a crapshoot. I do want to say, you know, I asked a couple people what this was selling for on their trading post, and nobody had an exact answer. But we did look at a few examples, and we saw around 3,500 to 4,500 in gold. So you can see here, it's only 1,500 to buy this. If you're able to just farm those faction tokens, they're pretty much paying for you to farm faction tokens if they don't, you know, if they just buy it off the trading post instead of buying it themselves. So keep that in mind, you know, 4,500 gold as a possibility here. So that's up to 3,000 gold per grand rune of holding. Like I said, guys, as more people know about this, there's going to be less money to be made. And obviously, as people catch up to you in level, depending on if you're, you know, higher level than them and you're able to, you know, get more of these out there on the market early game, there's going to be a lot of crafters wanting these. So just keep that in mind. People are going to be crafting bags, trying to make money off that, because there is a way to use these, like I said, to craft bags with great perks and make money with those bags as well. So I do want to kind of like explain, you know, this is a lot of money to be made very, very quickly. And I hope you guys kind of got that from this video. Just a kind of a quick tip video on how to make quick money. And you don't even need Alchemist to get any of the greater rune of holdings. That's one thing that a lot of people don't really realize. Tier 5 is actually at the, I'm not sure exactly how to say this, Cabalist or Cabalist. You guys let me know in the comment section down below. I need to learn exactly how to say that. But like I said, you don't even need the final tier Alchemist to get that tier 5 rune of holding. So I think this is going to be a great way to actually make gold in New World. I think there's going to be a lot of people excited about the ways to make gold in New World, because there's going to be so many different unique ways. I am kind of starting to ramble just a little bit. So thank you guys again for tuning in. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn notifications on. I really do appreciate the awesome support. I'll see you guys all in the next one.